Hey guys, welcome to Found Flicks. The missed TV series continues with episode 2, Withdrawal. If you missed my last video looking at the pilot, make sure to check that out first, as this week's episode expands slightly on the concepts introduced there. And just as in the pilot, the main focus of Withdrawal is on human drama, exploring the differing dynamics between the groups trapped in various locations, rather than revealing anything supernatural potentially going on. The issue is, with all these characters all over the place, the show is quickly falling into the trap of spreading out the story and characters too thinly between scenes. And the second episode didn't really do any better than the pilot in that regard. However, there still is some interesting stuff revealed in this episode in relation to the bigger mythology of the series. I considered last week that The Mist was able to tap into the deep regrets and pain that people have done in their lives and brings it to life via The Mist. This was only hinted at in the pilot, but this week more or less confirms this. The episode's main story is mostly about the troubled junkie Mia, and we see that via her encounter with the Mist. She was seen in the pilot returning to a home, only to discover that whoever she was looking for had been dead for months. She said it was only an old friend of hers, but that's obviously not the case. Later, she returns to the house to retrieve a bag full of money and passports, but ends up getting arrested. She's stopped right in front of a grave, clearly the woman that she was attempting to visit, and she says, "I'm not sorry," to the grave. Then in this episode, after Mia flips the car escaping from looters, outside the church she sees a vision of a woman. The woman calls out to Mia saying, "I miss you, baby doll," and stuff like that. Mia is in shock and chalks it up to her going through withdrawal, as the woman, she says, is dead. But it turns out that Brian actually saw the woman as well. So it wasn't only in her mind, and the Mist itself had manifested this woman that Mia hurt deeply in some way in order to get her to confront her past sins. I mean, the lady has to be her mom, right? Mia had lost contact with her for a few months, as that's how long the man now living in her house says it's been. I would wager that her mom had gotten sick, and Mia, being a criminal junkie, left her behind rather than tending to her ailing mother. And now Mia has to confront what she did and absolve for her sins. But my question is that something that's even possible? Like, if she goes out to her Mist mom and is like, "Mom, I'm sorry for real about being such a shitty druggie and for you dying and stuff," and the Mist would be all, "Okay, we cool," and leave her alone? I don't know, it's weird. There is still that shot from the trailer of Alex face to face with that swirly black thing. Could that literally be her confronting her own sins? Maybe. The other major events in the episode had to do with the development of Project Arrowhead. We already know that Brian was involved with them in some form, but he still has amnesia and doesn't mention anything new regarding his role there. But back at the mall, there is suddenly substantially more going on with Arrowhead. The mall group is trying to retrieve a radio from the security office, but discover that the Mist has leaked into the hallway. They decide to send a drone in to see if it's safe in what is kind of a ridiculous scene. "Oh gee, I sure hope the drone is okay." They see a window has been open, letting the Mist in, and discover a bloodied body slumped on the floor nearby. It looks like the Mist has a thing about going for the eyes, as this guy is missing one, as was the officer after being attacked last week by cockroaches. No one knows who the guy is, but in his final moments, he began to write some letters on the ground in his own blood. They suggest it might be Anna, but to me it sure looks like A-R-R-O, as in the beginning of Arrowhead. I'm not sure how helpful it would be to spell out that word before you die, but he seemed to think it was very important. He initially must have climbed into the window to escape whatever bugs were attacking him, then started writing before succumbing to his injuries. It could just be that he was also a part of Arrowhead, as there are in fact 4 already in the mall that we also meet this episode. In the beginning, Eve speaks to the mall manager about what happened to Mrs. Carmody, and someone calls out, "What was it?" We see that one guy, Clint, silences him, and there are 2 others with them in their group. It's confirmed that Clint is a part of Arrowhead when he and Eve set out to go to the radio. He tries to call out on some regular radio frequencies at first, but then dials in a special code, calling out for Arrowhead and referring to himself as Shadow 41. Eve sees he has a gun and she tries to ask more questions, but Clint starts to pull his gun out. Eve throws the radio case at him, leading to a fight. But so, Clint won't let her go here because he was already going to kill her? It's just weird, especially if he was always intending to kill her after contacting Arrowhead. Another odd detail during their fight: Clint is on top of Eve holding her down, but is momentarily distracted by a monster noise. I don't know what else you could call the sound that he hears. It's not a moose or a bear or whatever, but we don't actually see anything, of course. But it's this distraction that gives Eve the upper hand, and she actually kills Clint. Now, as far as the rest of Clint's crew, two are later found by Jay, having hung themselves in the bathroom. Another homage to the original, where the same thing happened to two Arrowhead soldiers. So perhaps Clint's crew actually didn't know that it was Arrowhead that caused the mist until they learned about it from the blood message from the dead guy. Then once they realized that it was indeed Arrowhead behind it, they knew how bad things would be and chose to take their own lives. But there still is one more of his buddies alive, and maybe he will fulfill the Private Jessup role in the original and actually give us some concrete information about Arrowhead's involvement in everything. That'll wrap it up this time for my investigation of the missed second episode. How did you guys like Withdrawal? What do you guys think of the show so far? Let me know your thoughts in the comments below. Make sure to like, subscribe, follow. Thanks for watching Found Flicks. See you next time. Stay misty, my friends.